Dead dog.
Our dog Max is gone.
Totally dead.
Resurrection.
Resurrection of a dog.
Well, basically, it wasn't our dog. It was our temporary dog, not from the shelter literally, but from some foundation that takes care about unwanted dogs. That's about some dogs that were found somewhere or treated badly. Hannah decided to take Max for 1 month, and it was already 2 months, so we just decided to ask for transferring Max to another temporary care. Max was really into human, into people, into contact with people. He was sold straight away when someone was petting him, playing with him. He was happy to be cuddled. He was coming in the morning to our bed, not getting into the bed because we didn't allow him, but he was just putting his head on the bed and looking at us, waiting for attention and probably to go out as well. He was well behaved in the way that he was wasn't doing a mess, except looking into the bin sometimes. But if straight comment Max Pui, and it was enough.
So when he will start doing it, I will shout at him. Good boy.
For me, it was interesting experience to have a dog, and that's what I would also recommend to people that didn't have a dog and feel somewhere that they would like to experience it. Maybe before taking a dog for a permanent time, for a lifetime, because that's how the dog should be taken. Taking dog as a temporary care, you're taking him because otherwise no one would take him, and he would get into the shelter. And how much is better to stay for the dog with even temporary care than living in a shelter, because shelter is shelter, many dogs in many small cages. Thanks to this, I've had an opportunity to see how it is to live with a dog and to experience also some duties, some responsibilities with the dog. Hannah was walking him more often, but still I was doing it as well. There was more hair at home to vacuum. It was getting dirty quite sooner than usually, even if it was Max didn't have long hair, it was still the case.
It's your saliva. And this is mud from your paw. It should be in a package. Do you think it is representative now? You don't really care, do you?
South of Prague, Branik, Prague 4. This is where Max will be living from now. I missed him a bit at least, because it was, well, there was another living being, me or Hannah or anyone actually was entering home, but especially us. He was showing affection. He was showing that he missed us.
On this video, you can see Max running perfectly happy, fine with another beagle. It's a beagle of a colleague from my work, and it was a surprise. We were contacted with her to get some tips about how to train Max, how to get rid of, or at least live with, his issues. Basically, when we walk him, when Max is outside and he approach other dog, a literally dog, male dog, he starts to bark. First he growls, even when he sees from a distance. He has amazing sight, because many meters further he can spot a dog. And when he pass next to other dog is passing next to him, he just barks and goes mad. Yeah, he's okay being a flat dog, a couch dog. But the other side of it is that he's a beagle, and he just likes to run. He just likes to be outside. Living in a flat with a dog that has hunting roots just doesn't feel good. He's just not meant to stay in a flat for a whole day. When we are at work, he needs a lot of movement, and that we couldn't even give him this move while being walked, just because he could get into the fight with other dogs, and we couldn't allow for this. He should end up perfectly at some family that has a garden, big garden, that he can run freely.
The link to the foundation is down below if you would like to participate, if you're interested in taking and helping such a dog. Having a dog also take some part of our headspace, and probably that's not what I'm looking for right now. I'm finding my balance, I'm finding my headspace.